morning, it's 7 o'clock, it's Monday the 6th of April, and you're watching The Bigger Breakfast all the way at 11:30.
Yes!
Hey!
Hey!
My name's Ant.
I'm Dec, and we're with you for the next 2 weeks while Johnny and Denise take a well-earned break. Enjoy your 2 weeks off
enjoy
there,
it,
you two.
Enjoy it in Whitley Bay. It's nice this time of year. It's lovely up there.
It is lovely. Sunshine and everything.
Oh, it is. For the next fun-packed fortnight, me and Dec are going to be the most envied men in the world because do you know
why?
Why
is that?
Guess who's joined us in the house?
Who?
The talented.
Gorgeous.
And I fancy her. Ooh. Melanie Sykes! Yeah! Yeah!
She's gorgeous.
She's absolutely lush.
What are they?
What
are they?
Presents for Melanie.
Oh, sorry, Aunt, I should have warned you.
What?
She really doesn't like things like that.
What, like presents?
No, she doesn't. She gets really offended. She just really play it cool.
Oh,
she
really?
Thinks you're trying to buy her, you see.
Oh, really?
Mm.
What am I going to do with these?
Well, I can take them off your hands if you want. I mean,
oh, yeah, I hope.
I'll try and get rid of 75 pence.
That sound okay. Yeah, if you just grab them.
All right, then. Well, here's gentlemen and ladies. Give it up for Melanie Sykes! Yay! Yay! Hey, Melanie.
Is somebody's birthday or what?
No, I just thought I'd buy you a couple of presents to welcome you to the show.
Thank you so much. I think we should go for lunch after the show.
That would be
lunch!
Really nice.
Yeah, lunch.
Lunch?
It's having us so nice of you. Thank you.
Thanks, Melanie.
Anyway, coming up on today's show...
At 7:05, Richard Owen offered sliding down a pole somewhere with firemen somewhere in Chester.
Oh! At 7:15, we look at some of nature's greatest abominations and our freakish new feature, Ugly Pets.
Ugly!
Yes, and at 7:20, we cruise the TV highway in our new love, Route to Midnight.
Mm. All that and a horrific encounter for the squeamish out there amongst you with this director and star of Scream 2, Wes Craven and David Arquette are live in the house.
And KJ and Jojo from Jordish will also be live in the house this morning.
Plus, we're getting up close and personal with the boys' own in a snap special.
Come on, Dec, let's go and have a cup of coffee.
Not you, you'll stay in there.
Now it's Katie Haswell with a big breakfast news.
Good morning, these are the main stories.
Thank you. So sweet.
It was so cute when all you showed was a shot of his bum before leaving. Katie, since it's your first week, how are you doing? How are you coping with the early mornings?
I can't hear you.
You cannot hear us. How are you coping with the early mornings up there?
I still can't hear you very well, I'm afraid.
Oh, okay, no.
We'll talk to you later.
Thanks
see
for
you
that.
Later.
Thank you. Now it's time to shout. Turn on the heat, Richard!
Bizarre throw line, but it will be explained, I promise you. It's Richard Orford here.
Cheers, Richard. I can do that.
What? We could do that, couldn't we? Rich, can you hear me, mate? Are you going to talk to us?
I can hear you.
Good morning, how are you?
I'm very well, thank you. I'm very excited to be part of the emergency services this week. If you phone 999, you can ask for police, ambulance, fire, or outside broadcast presenter available for bar mitzvahs, summer seasonal pants.
Cheers, mate. We'll see you later on in the morning, mate.
I will indeed.
See you later.
See you later.
Melanie.
Now, this morning, we're giving you the chance to choose your very own twos up for the whole week.
That's right, Aaron. We've come up with a really, really good idea. Instead of calling it twos up, because you choose it, we're going to call it... Choose
off! Yay! Yay! So clever.
What a gags in this, y'all.
Two's up.
Whoa! Yay! Call should cost no more than 10 pence and you can start registering your votes right now. Call now!
Now after the break, me and Ant are going to be entering the twisted world of ugly pets. But until then, this is Channel 4 and you're watching The Bigger Breakfast all morning! The boat at Calais,
uh-huh.
They made us wear a stripy like top,
uh-huh.
A beret, and like onions around my neck and kiss everybody on both cheeks.
Oh, right, I see. That's French customs for you, Dec.
Mm.
Mm. Oh, we're back on! Welcome back to The Bigger Breakfast, our man.
And I'm Dec, and now it's time for the part of the show that we call Ugly Pets.
What? I was just going to say ugly in a really madcap fashion, but...
You're crazy, you
are.
Sorry about that. Now, when I think of pets, you think of fluffy bunnies or cute little kittens, but there are some sort of household pets that aren't so cute.
No, they're ugly, Dec. They're ugly, very ugly.
Well, you can say they're less cute. I was trying to be polite about it.
But they are ugly, aren't they?
Well,
let's take a look. We've got Chris here from the Reptile House at London Zoo. Hello, Chris.
Morning.
Welcome
morning.
To the show. Now, that's an ugly pet. That's all I'm going to say on the matter. That's ugly.
It's not beautiful, but it's different.
It is different, but where would you get, an ugly pet like that from?
Well, you can buy these from pet shops, but the best place to get them is from captive breeders. There are many in the country.
And it's actually, what is it? It's a
bearded dragon from Australia.
A noggy bearded dragon, could you say?
Well, a pleasant looking bearded
dragon. He's not
too
bad. Does he have to shave?
He doesn't, no. No.
That's it. What?
I was just going to say, I shaved this morning.
What? First time.
Just blew it off. So, you know, where would one of these live? Where'd they come from then?
Well, they're from Australia and they live in the very hot sort of scrubby deserts out there. So they get very hot temperatures during the day. And if you're going to keep one of these as a pet, you have to sort of mimic those environmental conditions in the enclosure that you keep it.
So if they're all the way from like Australia and places, are they expensive to buy?
Not really, no. The captive bred ones, which are better to get because you know that the animal hasn't been taken from the wild, they can be somewhere in the region of around £30 for a baby.
Right.
But the equipment to actually look after the animal can cost up to £200.
And, right, I see.
And they must be difficult to look after then.
They can be difficult. As long as you know what you're doing and you read lots of information in books, then they're not that difficult.
So what type of stuff would that eat then? You know, because obviously it's not just like bread and milk that you give hedgehogs in the garden and stuff.
This is usually the bit that puts people off from wanting to keep these.
Right.
Because that is what they eat.
Oh, they're ugly cockroaches. And that's to be said.
These are field crickets, and that's about a meal's worth there.
So would you give them? Would you give them to the reptile live? Just put them in its
Yeah, you
its
have
tank?
To give them live, otherwise he won't recognise they're there, and they'll just sort of won't be eaten.
Right.
Well, that is an ugly pet. It has to be said, and I'm sure I'll be popping down to my local supermarket to get a little mini dino with a little beard. Thanks for coming on, Chris.
You're welcome.
Thanks a lot, mate. And you can see lots more ugly pets all the way this week on the Big Breakfast.
Now, I enjoy that, you see, that I am, because it's informative.
Yeah.
It's you know, viewer friendly, and it's just lots of fun.
Oh, it is. It's lots of fun. But you know, Dec, that's not the first time you've been seen in public with a dragon, is it? Saturday night.
But do you actually believe in the old adage, you know, that people actually begin to look like their pets after a while?
Oh yeah, undoubtedly yes. It has to be said very positively. Yes, I would say.
How
that.
Is your chimpanzee? Ah, I got you.
Yeah, he's all right. Here's the route to midnight.
Hi, my name is Arthur. This is where I work, Metropolitan Car Parks in Chelsea.
To the Bigger Breakfast. I'm Melanie Sykes.
I'm Ant McPartland.
And I'm glad I'm not.
So bitchy. Earlier we gave you the chance to vote for your very own Choose Up, cleverly called Choose
Up.
You've got just 3 more minutes to vote, and here's a reminder of what to do.
Choose is yours.
Oasis, that's 0891 4477 and add 01. And at the moment we've got 16% want Oasis.
Bad,
I don't think
bad.
That's high enough. I think it should be higher. Just personal. Queen.
Because you're mad for it from Manchester,
Maverick. We've got Queen, same number added to, and at the moment we've got 15%. Thank goodness. Wow, 26%.
Hey, that's not bad.
That's good.
That's Denise's bag, not mine. Prodigy, 19% we've got, and just add a 4 at the end of the number. And Kylie, 13%. And lastly, Duran.
Hey, Duran.
That should be higher.
Duran.
We like Duran. Of
course. Did you?
Yeah,
you like
I was a massive fan.
Wild boys.
What? Like did
that? Never went like
three
that.
Albums out, mate.
That was the operatic version.
Oh,
course cost 10 pence and you can start registering your votes. Well, you can still register your votes right now, but still to come on the Big Breakfast.
It's you.
At 7.30, it's Pop Democracy, as we find out who the winners are in Choose Up.
At 7.40, Buster Rhymes gets a rapturous response in Snap.
And at 7.45, Richard Orford fires up down Chester Fire Station. Ooh. And coming up, Zig and Zag meet. Casey and Jojo. I can't believe I forgot Mooney, just met him.
Plus, we'll be getting the willies when we meet up with Scream 2's David Arquette and Wes Craven.
And don't miss the chance this week to win 2 fantastic competitions, 2 trips to America, all this week on the Big Breakfast.
Wow.
So like every day.
Every day, that is.
And if that wasn't enough to whet your appetite, we've also... Just hold on, you.
Sorry.
We've got part one of a Snap special on Boyzone. Well, then they'll be telling us about the highs and the lows of fame.
As you know.
As you do.
As you do know. As right now, it's time for Katie Aswell with the Bigger Breakfast news and weather. Yay!
Morning. These are the main stories on Monday the 6th of April.
Thank you very much, Katie. Now it's time to sort out the losers from the choosers. Did I get that right? Choosers and losers.
That's fine. fine.
Is that good?
That's how you do an all right.
Sorry, because I get a little bit scared, a little bit paranoid. Is it okay?
That's fine.
Honestly.
Wow. It's fine.
It's all right, man.
Just tell me again.
Yeah, brilliant.
I'm doing great. Thanks.
And the winners are The Prodigy and Wham, and we'll be hearing them all week. So take it away.
Two's up.
You got it.
Wow. They spent more money on their hair than they did on shooting a video. Did you know it's Wham?
I used to love Wham.
I did. So did
Joe, didn't you, Joe?
Loved him. My favourite band ever.
Didn't they? Just come in a minute. What is it you said during the video there? Wow.
It was the 80s.
Yeah.
No, I knew all the dance routines.
Well,
come on then.
That's right, you knew all the routines. Coming up after the break, we've got Busta Rhymes picking it up in Snap.
Plus, Casey and JoJo from Jodeci are live in the house, and we also get intimate with Boyzone in a Snap special.
But Feisty, this is Channel 4, and you're watching The Bigger Breakfast.
On today's hair-raising Big Breakfast, we...
Welcome back to The Bigger Breakfast. Now it's time for my favourite part of the show, Question of the Day.
I like that. Now, it's coming up to exam time, and I don't know if you're like me, but I used to hate exams.
Yeah.
Did you? So we want to hear your exam horror stories, and I think we've got... And if you tell us them, you could win this. Look at this. Come down here. Come down here.
Yeah, that, come down here.
This bump and letter revision pack. You see it? You see it there? We've got the book in there. We've got coffee to keep you awake. We've got nice little chocolate fingers.
I love them chocolate fingers.
So do I. We've got everything in there. Everything for... to revise by, and we've got Sorty. You didn't like your exams, did you?
No, especially not a maths exam. I thought I'd finish the whole lot, sitting back, relaxing. Only then did I realise that I actually hadn't turned over the first page. So.
Well, if you think you could do better than that, then give us a call on 0181 985 all. Now it's time for this morning's Music Snap with Busta Rhymes.
Ant Dec and Melanie in the house.
Collect.
Yes, calling now. What are you doing, man?
It's gone mad. Today we're giving away a whole host of Ministry of Sound goodies.
Come on.
Including their entire back catalogue, magazine and merchandise, as well as a mixing desk.
That's what they do, you know, in the clubs, Melanie.
Go on, darling. Wow.
Call in now and answer the simple question. Which famous... Stop that.
Shake it, baby, shake it!
Which famous pop group did Boy George front? Was it A, Culture Club, B, Brownie Club, or C, Breakfast Club? You all right, mate?
Yes, carry on.
If you think you know the answer to that question, then give us a call on 0891 22 99 00. Culture Club's no more than 25 pence, but if you're under 18, please ask an adult for permission. Still to come, we take a look at the movers and the shakers in this week's brand new Top 10. Are you all right?
I'm a bit knackered now.
We catch up with Boys On in a very special Snap.
That's right. It's part of me, isn't it? It's Gorgolo. I'm all carried away. It's Gorgolo as we two freshly nice chaps.
It's Gorgolo.
Wes Craven and David Arquette from the new movie Scream 2 are live in the house.
Yes! You're going to take a rest, son. Thank you. Right now, you're watching Channel 4 and this is The Bigger Breakfast.
On today's hair-raising Big Breakfast.
Welcome back to The Bigger Breakfast, all the way with you till 11:30. Now, just before the break, we give you a chance to win lots and lots of Ministry of Sound goodies. And we've got a winner, Declan.
We have got a winner. The winner is Alec Box from Folkestone.
Congratulations, Alec.
Very well done.
He knew that Boy George used to front Culture Club. Isn't he clever?
Very clever.
And that wasn't paradise at all.
Not at all. Stay tuned for our competition, Ooh, What a Lovely Pair, to be in with a chance to win a trip to Universal Studios in Florida. Wow. And that's at 8:45. But here's what's still to come.
Next up, it's this week's killer tunes in the brand new Top 10.
And at 8:02, spine tingling action when we meet David Arquette and Wes Craven from Scream 2.
at 8:05, Casey and Jojo from Jodeci have an alien encounter with Zig and Zag.
Plus at 8:40, you could win a year's supply of chocolate and a trip for two to Universal Studios in Florida in our competition, What a Lovely Pair.
Plus, we'll be entering the Zone of Boy in a very personal snap special on Boyzone.
Yes, but now it's time for this week's Top 10.
Joe's wham dancing.
He knows all the routines, apparently.
Well, there we have it. That's this week's top 10. And isn't it great to see Daniel O'Donnell crashed into the top 10 there?
Yay!
How happy are we?
I'm very happy.
Championing from the beginning here at the Big Breakfast last time we were on.
Oh, well, that's just the way it is. But now, with the time at exactly 8 o'clock, let's go over to Katie Haswell for the Big Breakfast news and weather.
Good morning. These are the main stories on Monday the 6th.
Thanks very much, Katie. Now, all morning, we've been asking you to phone and fax us with your answers to our topical teaser. That is Question of the Day. Earlier, we asked you to phone and fax us with your exam horror stories, and you've got a couple there.
Yes, certainly have. I've got this one from Sam in Berkshire. Sam said, at the start of a mock exam, I read the first sheet, and the instructions were to read carefully through all of, the questions before answering, but I couldn't be bothered. After about half an hour's work on the first section, I'd finished it and turned the page to read, you didn't have to answer all those questions. That was a test to see if you'd read through it carefully.
Now mine isn't that funny.
So they're not going to be winning the revision pack then, are they?
Oh, okay, sorry about that. No, but Sophie from Hertfordshire...
Don't cry, Sophie, it's all right.
To run while sitting in my maths exam. After a few sniffs, I realised that it was a bad nosebleed and it went all over on the exam paper. Yeah. Poor little thing. Keep them coming because we've got this very smart revision pack to give away. Look at that. That's fantastic. And the number to call is
0818 1 8 1 8 5 0 2.
But now, please welcome to the house director Wes Craven and star of Screen 2, David Arquette. Yeah. Hi, guys.
Hello.
You
too.
Now, you had the premiere, didn't you, on Friday night?
Yes,
How was it? Did you have a good party?
Fantastic.
Wonderful.
Had a good time?
Mm-hmm.
Well, we're going to be talking to you a bit later on.
Yeah, we're going to be talking to you later on, fellas. But now it's over to Zig and Zag with Casey and Jojo in the hallway. Zig and Zag!
Thanks, guys!
Thank you,
Melanie, Ant Dec and Melanie!
The lady!
Zig and Zag. Now, never believe everything you read in the papers. That's what my mum told me.
Good advice.
Sound advice. Cheers, mum. Now, we're going to put those words of wisdom to the test as we invite to the show the Sun's associate editor, Andy Coulson. Andy! Yay! Welcome to the show.
Thanks very much. Time for It Can't Be True.
What? It's not that exciting, those titles.
That kind of caught me short.
Okay.
Now then, Andy's got three stories from his fine publication, the Sun newspaper, but only two are true. One is a red herring. We're going to try and find out which one.
So, Andy, what's your first story?
The first story is about a film fan, Jean Chitrin, who had to flee the cinema as she was watching the Titanic because she felt seasick. Don't laugh. Now, charity worker Jean was sent giddy by the early scene in which Kate Winslet sort of looking over the side of the boat.
Oh, right, yeah,
she looks
at
that and just.
So that was it.
Started feeling a bit ill. Yeah. That's not the first time she's had this problem. Apparently, she got car sick when she watched Speed.
You're joking.
Fortunately, she hasn't been able to see Free Willy yet.
Story two.
Eric Clapton should be worried. Tony Blair is about to spend his Easter holiday in Spain learning how to play the flamenco guitar. He's going to have lessons with Maestro Paco Pena, who's taught him in secret for years. which is great. Of course, Clinton's very good.
What do you think?
Oh, be true!
Oh, damn it.
Now, the third story.
Third story.
The Millennium Dome, it seems, is haunted and needs to be exorcised. It's haunted by the ghost of Mary Ellis, who apparently is a 17th century nurse who ran a hospice on the site of the dome. And the Reverend Derek Forsyth says that it's going to take 35 gallons of holy water to get things.
What do you think?
Oh, can it? Now, which story is the fake one? After the break, we'll be asking you, and we'll be asking ourselves, which one is the fake one, and which two are true?
But for now, this is Channel 4, and you're watching The Bigger Breakfast.
On The Bigger Breakfast, get into gear with Boyzone.
Join us in the Fast Lane and find out what it's like to be in one of Ireland's biggest successful bands, only on The Bigger Breakfast.
Don't miss out, because we'll be driving you crazy.
Yes, before the break, we heard three fantastic, amazing... Where am I? There I am. Three fantastic, amazing stories from the Sun's associate editor, Andy Coulson. Two of which were true, but one which was pure baloney.
Pure baloney.
Pure baloney. Let's have a quick recap, Andy, on those three stories.
Okay.
Story one
was about the film fan, Gene Tritrin, who had to flee the cinema whilst watching Titanic because she felt seasick.
It can't be true! Yeah. I don't know, what do you reckon about that?
I reckon that's a bit far-fetched.
But she's done it before, you said. She went to see Speed and she done it before?
Speed, got car sick, yeah.
I don't know. I'm not sure about that. Story two.
Not convinced.
Story two. Prime Minister Tony Blair is going on holiday to Spain to have flamenco guitar lessons.
I think he's flashy enough to do something like that.
He's got twiddly fingers, hasn't he?
Yeah.
That's what Spurs is. Has he? I've seen them, aye.
Well, yeah. Okay. And question there, story three?
Story three is the dome's haunted and it's going to need to be exorcised with 35 gallons of holy water.
Can't be true. Well, Andy, I don't know. I mean, I reckon, you know, I've got my own thought to me.
Yeah.
But, you know.
What do you reckon?
I reckon story three, you know, story three. 35 yeah. gallons of holy water. Pure baloney. Can't be true. Can't be true.
Let's check them then. Let's have a look. Story one then.
You're going to look so silly.
There's nothing new about that, Andy.
You sure you don't have to change your mind?
Nah, story three.
Change your mind.
I'm still not convinced about story one, I have to say.
Story one, you think?
I'm not convinced. I think this might be the red herring.
Really? Yeah. Okay.
Let's have a look.
How do you feel?
Pretty stupid. Pretty stupid.
Story two.
Tony Blair.
Story two.
Yeah.
Could be the big surprise.
Could be.
Twiddly fingers! Story three!
We've rather ruined things here.
Just a bit, yeah. Oh, I wonder.
Pure baloney!
What do you know? Just before you go, Andy, what's the big story in the Sun today?
Oh, we've got a great story today. Big lottery win, 3.5 million winner. She's a 16-year-old pregnant schoolgirl.
Whoa.
She was worried about how she was going to afford to bring the baby, and now she's got plenty of cash.
Fantastic.
Congratulations to her.
Best of luck.
Well done.
Now then, if you're a little bit squeamish like Ant here, it's time to hide behind the cushions because we've got David Arquette, is that how you say it? David Arquette and Wes Craven coming up from Scream 2. Scream, not screen, Scream, and they're with Zing Zag.
Over to Mel and Ant and Dec.
Thanks, boys. Thanks, but now it's time for some saucy matchmaking as we ask you to play Oh, What a Lovely Pair.
Ooh, what a lovely pair.
If you win today, you could win a trip to Florida and a year's supply of chocolate.
Whoa.
Take a look at this.
You could win a year's supply of M&Ms plus a holiday for two.
All you have to do to be in a chance to win that fantastic prize is to ring us and tell us the answer to this very simple question. And the question is, which fruit is Florida's most famous for? Is it A, oranges, B, bananas, or C, kumquats?
If you think you know the answer, give us a call on...
Oi, that wonderful
four-double-seven-double-four! That's...
Oi, that wonderful four-double-seven-double-four!
should cost no more than 25 pence and we'll be playing at 8:45.
Still to come, I get a good spooking when I meet David Arquette. Scream too. I'm looking forward to that.
Good.
But first, this is Channel 4 and you're watching The Bigger Breakfast. Yay! Hiya, Donnelly.
Hey. All morning we've been phoning, you've been phoning and faxing us with your answers to our question of the day, telling us your worst exam stories. And we've got a few faxes here.
Well, yes. I've got one. Can okay. I go first? You don't mind. This is from Grace Shaw in Stenhouse Muir. My son Colin went into school to do one of his exams and was told he was a day late. That's pretty
silly
bad.
Boy.
Silly boy.
Silly little silly boy. Mark from Hertfordshire says, I didn't know many answers on my exam, so on every answer I didn't know, I wrote NFFC, Nottingham Forest Football Club, as the answer, and he passed.
No!
He reckons he passed.
Well done.
This is the winner. It's Jenny from Cardiff. During an exam, my friend was dying to break wind. To disguise the noise, she coughed, but she mistimed it and everybody heard. I laughed so much, I got asked to leave. So, Jenny from Cardiff, congratulations to you. Well, this revision kit will be coming to you soon. Yay! Come on this morning's gigantic show. After the news, hair-raising stuff as we meet with Wes Craven and David Arquette from Scream 2.
At 8:45, the first of our five-pod boys on Snap.
At 8:50, we'll be giving away a holiday for two to Universal Studios in our Ace competition. Ooh, what a lovely pair. But now, with the time at 8:28, it's over to Katie with the news and weather.
Morning. Is a stand-up.
I'm Melanie Sykes, and I've got two glamorous assistants, Ant and Dec, with me all the way till 11:30. Yay!
Thanks. Now, we're just looking at the papers there in the break, and it's all about the Spice Girls who kicked off their tour in Glasgow this weekend. I love the Spice Girls.
Mate. I love the Spice Girls.
I think they're fantastic, too.
What do you think of the Spice Girls, lads? Do you know the Spice Girls?
I love the Spice Girls.
Yeah?
Yeah, oregano, I love.
Oregano.
Oregano.
Sorry, Gano, love.
No, it was their opening night in Glasgow.
In Glasgow. There was loads of celebs up there as well for the first night, wasn't there? We all got invitations, didn't we?
Yeah, but we just couldn't be bothered to go,
couldn't
we?
No, we weren't.
Think of all them parties.
Yeah. No, we've got some stories here, and it's funny because Jerry didn't seem too impressed with the whole thing, did she?
No.
She looked a bit upset. Now, it says here in the Daily Star, and you can trust this paper, man, it says that the Star's rave reporter, Rav Singh, said her sad look was the talk of the crowd. Her eyes seemed puffy and bloodshot like she'd been crying, and she seemed distracted and very unhappy.
No, poor thing. I've got one here, though. It says, it's in the Sun. The girls gave one of their finest live performances yet with a tearful Jerry's emotional rendition of the ballad Denying, one of the highlights. The hits have never sounded better and now take personal offence that the show-stopping stop only made it to number two.
What's going on?
What's going on?
Glasgow? Huh?
If you were there.
Jay, like, what's going on, Jay?
Jay
Springer.
What is it, girl? What is it? If
you were, you ain't all that, Jay.
Whatever.
If you were there up in Glasgow last night and you seen Jerry crying off, you know what's going on. Just give us a ring and let us know what you thought of it.
Yes.
The number to call is 0181.
Or fax us on
0181.
But now it's time to turn up the heat with Richard when we shout,
Turn up the heat, Richard!
Hello, yes, good morning to you. We're really bizarre, isn't it? Yeah!
Ooh, what a lovely pair.
Yay! It could be simpler. This house has 20 windows. In each window is a different celebrity.
Now, altogether, they make up 9 pairs of celebrity couples. A bit like Ant and myself.
Yeah.
Even though we're not a couple.
No.
All celebrities.
What's your lip, Missy? Now, there are also 2 celebrities in there who are all alone. They're not a duo. They're red herrings. Also a bit like Ant and myself.
Hey! Now, if you can find yourself one pair of celebrity couples, you could win a year's supply of chocolate.
Whoa! Yes!
Or a trip to Universal Studios in Florida, because what do pairs make?
A really good surprise!
All right, then, we've got 3 callers on the line here. Who's on line one?
Line one. Hello?
It's Pete from Medway.
Hello, Pete. You feeling lucky?
I am feeling lucky, yeah.
Good mate, stay on the line. Call number 2.
Hello?
Hello?
Alison, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Good morning, Alison.
Where are you calling from?
From Eastbourne.
Good luck to you.
Thank you.
And over on line three, good luck.
We've got
Pat. Are you there, Pat?
Yeah, I'm here.
And where are you calling from?
From Margate.
Good luck to you.
Here's how you play. We have 2 minutes to play the game. I'll ask each of you in turn for two numbers. We'll open the shutters, and if you've picked a celebrity pair, you win a trip to Florida. Woo-hoo! If you fail to pick a pair, we'll go on to the next caller. Can I have 2 minutes on the clock, please?
All right.
Here it is. Caller one, can I have your first two numbers, please?
14 and 6.
14.
14. Griffith Jones.
6.
6.
Eddie Wise.
It's not a pair, but remember where you saw, who you saw.
Get it right next time.
Sorry.
Okay, caller two.
Alison.
Close that one.
11.
11.
Okay, here we are. And Ronnie Corbett and?
6.
6.
No, 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 no.
She said, oh, no. Oh, yes. Not a pair, but remember who you saw.
Okay. Where you saw her.
Call agree, Pat.
17.
17, down here. Jennifer Saunders.
Number 10.
Here we are.
Eddie Lodge, not a pair.
But remember who you saw.
Who you saw.
Oh, good. Okay, we'll go back to Peter. Peter.
Three. 11.
Ronnie Barger.
And
11. Ronnie Corbett.
Corbett.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Peter.
It's Peter.
Well done, Peter, mate. You'll just get yourself a trip to Florida. How'd you feel?
Brilliant, marvellous.
And the chocolate.
We'll be playing that again tomorrow, so everybody's got a chance to win. We're going to be playing it all week. Isn't
fantastic.
That smashing?
That's great. Well done, mate.
Remember, you saw it here on The Bigger Breakfast on Channel 4.
Yay! Coming up, he's the man who's made 11s is sexy. You know the body.
Fantastic stuff. Congratulations once again to Peter, who's won a year's supply of chocolate. And also a trip to where you...
It's what Homer Simpson does, you know, the Simpsons, when he sees food, when somebody sees hot dog.
And what else did he win?
Oh, you're coming back to me now. And he also won a trip to Universal Studios.
Obviously, to Declan, not as impressive as the air supply of chocolate. But before the break, we were telling you about Jerry from the Spice Girls being a little bit upset at the gig in Glasgow. But we've got it on good authority from Warren Flood in Glasgow, who was at the concert. I was at the Spice Girls concert and Jerry was not crying, she was very happy.
So,
who do you believe, the Daily Star or Warren Ford? Ooh. I don't know.
I know who my money's on.
But now, with the time at 8:56, it's Katie Haswell for the final Bigger Breakfast news and weather.
Top stories, Vauxhall.
How's your first day gone?
How's my what gone?
Your first day.
Oh, great. Great. Apart from having to get up early in the morning.
I know, it's a bit of a pain that bit, isn't it?
It's a killer.
It's a killer.
Somebody said you're gorgeous. Now. I don't know who it was. You've got some fancy. Hey. Oh, hey. You are gorgeous. Hey. He's blushing, he's blushing. Hey. Anyway, Katie, thank you. We'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow. Bye.
Bye. Bye, Katie.
Okay, and we've got to go over to Richard now. Richard, are you there?
I am indeed here, and I've been here all morning. I'm going to be here all week at Chester Fire Station with the lads from Blue Watch. Just been on a training mission for us round the corner. Did you find
thank
it?
Thank you
very much. See you tomorrow.
Thank you.
See you tomorrow,
thanks very much, mate.
See you thank tomorrow. You.
Cheers. Also, we wanted to say a big congratulations to Newcastle United.
Yay! Yay! What did they do?
I'm sorry.
What did they do?
What did they do?
What is it that they did?
They're in the FA Cup final now.
Oh, are they?
Yeah. No, I'll tell you a really interesting fact, actually, because me and Ant have been supporting.
And Arsenal, congratulations.
Yeah, I know Arsenal. But since we've been alive, me and Ant, this is the first time we've actually legitimately gone to Wembley with Newcastle United in our lifetime.
Yeah, it's good.
All right, don't look too impressed. You look, you know what I mean?
Nah, I'm not really.
Oh,
not. It's not something to boast about.
Who do you support? Do you follow football now?
I don't follow football. It doesn't interest me in the slightest, but I'd obviously have to go for a Manchester team, either City or United. But seeing as it'd have to be City because all Southerners support United.
That's
for some unknown reason. That's not the only thing I do know about football.
Well, they're not doing so good, are they, City, at the moment?
What?
They're not doing so good, City, at the moment.
I don't care.
She's really not bothered, is she? Let's
I'm
not talk the football.
Not bothered. Anyway, let's thank today's guests.
Yeah.
Thank you to Casey and JoJo from Jodeci. Big cheer for them. The fabulous David Arquette and his dog chain. And of course, the resident zigzag.
Thanks a lot to that ugly lizard and Chris from the Reptile House. Thanks a lot, mate.
And the gorgeous Andy Coulson.
Take it easy, hey. Mate. Going to be here after 9 o'clock with loads of brilliant programmes. Keep tuned. See you later.
See you later. Hey.
You can win the video of the blockbuster movie Men in Black.
It's your chance to win a brilliant holiday to New York in our seasonal competition, Easter Bungee.
We're just throwing holidays at the people.
I know.
We're throwing holidays at you.
Very, just, very generous.
Just sending you to America.
All you have to do.
Great.
Can I?
Sorry.
Go on.
All you have to do to be a part of this is phone in and answer a question about one of the forthcoming programmes, starting with Moesha.
Now, if you answer the question correctly, and selected randomly by the computer, you'll be the first of one of four lucky contestants who joins in for the chance of a holiday at 11:20 this morning.
Just throwing them away.
Just throwing them away. The question about Moesha is, now listen very carefully, how many years in a row has Kim been voted the biggest big mouth?
You're big mouth,
you
Jay.
Got big mouth on you, girl. You got a big mouth on you,
question
sister.
Again. How many years in a row has Kim been voted big mouth? The number to call is 0891 double four double seven double four. And calls should cost, you know, more than 25p.
You've got a big... Now you're watching The Big Breakfast and starting to sit back, relax. And this is Moesha. Yeah.
Yeah. I like my body, especially my butt.
Your tail's bent, no one likes you, you smell.
Yeah, that's good. What's going on here?
You're just annoying.
I'm just having the dog put down.
You're the most ridiculous dog on the planet. Get run over, Roman.
Yeah, he's definitely learned his lesson there, Melanie. Well done.
Thanks for that.
All right.
Yeah, that's
welcome brilliant. Back to The Bigger Breakfast.
Well, welcome back.
Live again until 11:30.
We're just trying a little bit of a jolt there. Went down bad with the crew. Sorry about that, you know.
Yeah, it's a bit weak. Bit weak.
Who cares?
Now, before Moesha, we asked the question, how many years has Kim been voted biggest mouth?
And the answer was, of course, 3 years in a row.
You're big mouth for 3 years, Kim.
She had a big mouth.
Big mouth.
Now, our winner was Esther from Crawley, who goes onto the Easter Bungee board there. And she's the first one of four who will be going for the holiday at 11:20. So good luck to you.
Yes.
Good luck to you.
But now it's time for the first of today's over 65 contenders in the Bigger Breakfast singing competition, Grannyoki.
Each day we'll have three talented grandmothers singing top karaoke hits right here in our very own Grannyoki living room. Whoa. Now the winning nana will go forward to our grand final.
I like it.
But today's lucky winner will also have this little prize to take home with them, a beautiful Grannyoki trophy.
Yeah. What about that?
First up today, give a warm welcome please, it's Connie Moore. How are you feeling, Connie?
I'm feeling fine.
You feeling all right?
Yeah.
You're all tuned up there in the vocal cords?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You sure?
I suppose I'm over tuned if I had a whiskey.
Wouldn't we all have?
Well, all of today's grannies will be singing the same song, but what will that song be? Mel?
Ant Dec, Connie, mm-hmm. The song today will be Take That, Relight My Fire. Yay!
Fantastic. So, here, ladies and gentlemen, singing Take That, Relight My Fire is Connie Mark. We're going to give you a showbiz 3, 2, 1. You ready, everybody? In 3, 2, 1. Take it away,
Connie.
Biggest faith feeling of insecurity. Ah, ah, I need it so much, don't make it really need me.
When you ready, when you ready. Oh, Connie, we love you all.
We all stand up in the name of the Lord.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we
go. Here we go. Here we go.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
Here we
go. Here we
go. Relight my fire. Yeah.
She's away. She's off.
So baby, in the middle. Relight my fire. Cause I need.
Yeah. Thank you, Connie. Thanks very much. There'll be two more singing grannies later on in the show, competing for the coveted Grannyoki prize.
This could only be the Bigger Breakfast where the talent shines and where you stand the chance to win all of this.
You could win the video of the blockbuster movie Men in Black.
We saw Connie singing Relight My Fire. Connie, are you there? Connie, hello.
I'm here, yes.
I know this is a bit of a rude question, Connie, but how old are you?
I'm 74 going on 75. Yeah.
How long have you been singing?
Pardon?
How long have you been singing?
All my life.
All your life.
Are you a fan of Take That, Connie? Have you heard of them before?
I love Take That. I've got all the tapes.
Have you?
Yes, yes. Hey.
What about them? I like them other ones. What do you call them? PJ and Duncan. Did you like them?
No.
No, she didn't like them.
Got it. They did ask.
Have you ever done karaoke?
I have. We got chucked off karaoke once.
Oh, we did, yeah.
Where was that?
We got bored.
Well, we sang the Sex Pistols. What was it again? My Way. You know My Way?
Yeah.
But we left all the swearing in, so we got chucked out. It was in the BBC bar. Let's say that. The BBC bar in Newcastle when we were on Bighty Grove, and we were quite young. And
very naughty.
It is very naughty.
Very, very naughty.
Anyway, this morning, it's your chance to win a brilliant holiday to New York in our seasonal competition, Easter Bungee.
All you've got to do to be in with a chance of playing is answer a simple question about one of the forthcoming programmes. And next up, we've got The Secret World of Alex Mack.
Oh, yeah. We like that.
He loves it.
It's brilliant.
If you answer the question correctly and you're randomly picked by the computer, you will then go forward to be in Easter Bungee, which is coming later on about 11:20. It all gets very complicated.
It does, doesn't it? And the question is...
Today's question...
Go on, do it.
Shall
I do it?
You do it.
What is the colour of...
Do you want me to do it?
You do it.
I'll do it. What's the colour of Alex's dad, George's cat, when he enters the kitchen? The colour of his cat when he goes in the kitchen.
What is the colour of Alex's dad, George's cat, when he enters the kitchen? And the number to call is... 08914 77 44 08914 77 44 And calls should cost you no more than 25 pence.
You're watching The Bigger Breakfast. Now sit back and relax for The Secret World of Alex Mack.
You like it?
Yeah!
I'm Alex Mack. I was just laughing.
Really feel like I am Tom Jones, you know, it really worries us.
Does it? It's not unusual.
No, it's not.
That was a good one.
That was a good one.
No, Melanie didn't like it.
Timing was perfect.
Welcome back to The Big Breakfast. We're here with you all the way till 11:30.
Before Alex Mack, we asked the question, what is the colour of George's cap when he enters the kitchen?
And the answer, of course, was red. He had a red cap on, Jane!
Yeah.
Red, you want to watch that red cap when you're here, Jane?
You've been watching too much Jerry Springer, haven't you?
Of course you have.
It's all like, woo, baby. Woo.
Don't go there.
Anyway, our second... Our second lucky winner is Clive from Worthing.
Well done, Clive.
Clive's up on
Easter Bungee board. You'll be playing in our Easter Bungee competition at 11:20 this morning. So congratulations and good luck.
But now it's time for the second contender in the Bigger Breakfast singing competition, Granny Oakley.
Granny Oakley! Each day we've got three singing grannies and they're going to be competing for this Granny Oakley Award. Yeah, and if they do win today, they'll go through to Friday, which we've got our grand final.
Because it's like a big final, but he said grand instead of grand because it's granny.
But if they win today, they will go home with this. And today we've got Jane.
Jane! Come on down!
Welcome to the show, Jane.
Hi.
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Good.
You're all tuneful in the throat area?
No, not at all.
Oh, dear.
You're a little bit nervous there, are you, Jane?
I am a little.
I just get nervous before I start to sing.
Oh. Oh. Did you?
I didn't sound that good either, did I? It sounded like I was singing karaoke all the time.
I wasn't going to say a word. So anyway, ladies and gentlemen, here we are. It's Jane Dominin. Is that right, Jane?
That's right.
Dominin. Singing Relight My Fire once again. We'll give you a big showbiz 3, 2, 1. You ready, everyone? And 3, 2, 1. Here we go.
Of insecurity. Aha. I need you so much, but I don't think you really need me.
Everybody!
Ha ha. But if we all stand up in the name of love, woo! And state the case of what you're dreaming of, woo! But to say I only dream of you, woo! But like a thief in the night, you took away the love that I knew. Your love is my only desire. Relight my fire, 'cause I need your love.
Thanks very much, Jane. We've only got one more granny left to go on the show.
That was pretty good.
That was fantastic, Jane.
Did you enjoy that?
What do you think of your performance? Do you think it was all right?
Mediocre.
Oh, it was fantastic. What do you think, Jane?
Jane, how close do you think you are to that? Jane.
Sorry, big pardon.
Do you like to touch it?
About that close?
I thought she was very good. Well done.
Thank you.
So did I.
Do your grandchildren like you singing and stuff? Do you sing quite a lot of karaoke around the house? Yeah?
Not in the house, up the club where I work.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Are you a big fan of Take That, then?
My children are.
Oh, really?
My daughters.
Who do you like? Who's your favourite singer?
My favourite singer, Patsy Cline.
Oh! Oh,
good choice. Crazy. Good choice.
Crazy for
feelings.
Anyway, this is going to be the bigger breakfast. I'm going to be carried away there. And you can stand a chance to win all of this.
Ooh. You could win the video of the blockbuster movie.
Go ready. Welcome back to the bigger breakfast.
Granny, I came all the way from Newcastle upon Tyne to see you.
This morning, it's your chance to win a brilliant holiday to New York in our seasonal competition, Easter Bunge.
All you've got to do if you want to play is answer a simple question on one of the forthcoming programmes. And our next programme is Saved by the Bell.
Do we like Saved by the Bell?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Knockout.
It's a hit. Anyway, if you answer the question correctly and your name is randomly selected by our computer, you will be the third of four people to go forward in the grand final, the Easter Bunge game at 11:20. If you win it, we'll give you a blooming holiday.
And what's that question again, Mel?
The question, shall I do the question?
Do the question. Or do you want to do it? Here we go. You do it and then I'll repeat it.
All right, then. That's fair. The question. The question is, what instrument does Maria play in the band?
What instrument does Maria play in the band? And the number to call is...
0891 44 77 44.
That's 0891 44 77 44. And calls should cost you no more than 25 pence.
And if they do, you're being dipped. You're watching the big breakfast, and now it's Saved by the Bell. Come on! Yay!
When I wake up in the morning and the alarm gives out a warning, I don't think I'll ever make it on time. By the time I grab my books and I get up.
Welcome back to the bigger breakfast. How are you? Hope you're feeling well. We're here till 11:30. Live with you all the way. We've got the answer to the question about the programme, and the instrument Maria plays in the band was, of course, the keyboard.
We've got one lucky winner.
We've got Joan on there. She joins the board. Joan from the Isle of Wight. You're our third lucky winner. One more left on the Easter Bungie, and we give you a holiday.
Fantastic.
Couldn't be simpler at all.
But now it's time for the third of today's contenders in the bigger breakfast singing competition, Granny Oaky.
Yes! Yay! Every day we've got three grannies right here in our Granny Oaky living room singing karaoke hits, all waiting to win this coveted prize, the Granny Oaky Trophy.
It's a beautiful thing.
But if they do win this, and they do win today, we've got a granny coming up now, they can also go through to Friday, which is our grand final.
Grand final.
I really like that, Joe.
I like that, because I said grand.
And it means like grand.
You know what I mean?
But anyway, all right. Chill out, Jay, chill out. Coming up now, our next granny, give her a warm welcome, it's Queenie Roberts. How are you doing, Queenie?
Not too bad.
You all right?
Nervous?
Yes.
Oh, don't be nervous. Are you all tuned up and ready to go?
Well, we'll say ready to go.
All right. And if you don't mind me asking, I know it's not a very gentlemanly thing to ask, but how old are you?
78.
Fantastic.
That's fantastic.
I'm really only 19 and a half, because I'm a leap year baby.
Oh, fantastic. Brilliant. Well, all of our grannies will be singing the same song this morning, which is Take That's Relight My Fire. So if you're ready, Queenie, we'll give you a big showbiz 3-2-1 and we'll go for it. So are we ready?
Yeah.
In 3, 2, 1.
Take
it away.
This feeling of insecurity. I need you so much, but I don't think you really need me. But if we all stand up in the name of love and state the case of what you're dreaming of. I've got to say I only dream of you. But like a thief in the night, you took away the love that I knew.
Relight my fire.
Yeah. Your love is my only desire. Light my fire. I need your love.
Queenie. That was fantastic, Queenie. Well done. And I like the movement, a little bit of dancing there. You can give
I've worked out a different plan to that. I want to do quite a bit of this. Queenie!
Yeah. I like that.
Great
like
moves there.
Like this, in the track, it was a music. I could go like this, but you haven't got it here for me. No.
Thanks very much, Queenie.
Thanks, Queenie.
It's really fun. Yeah. I've got over it now.
You can relax now. We'll find out later on who's going to win and go through to the grand final on Friday.
Who's going to head?
Who's going to pass that, Queenie? It's all right.
She's stealing the show.
There's one dance. She thinks she can do it all.
This has got to be the bigger breakfast. Stay tuned because you could win all of this.
You could win the video of the blockbuster movie Men in Black, starring...
Jane and Queenie. So
relight my fire. Yay.
She's on. She's
on. So baby, yeah. Relight my fire. 'Cause I need your love.
And our second fantastic granny was Jane. Take it away, Jane.
Your love is my only desire.
Sing along.
Relight my fire, 'cause I need your love.
Well done.
And of course, who could forget Queenie?
Your love is my only desire. Light my fire. I need your love.
They were all fabulous.
If it was up to me, ladies, if it was up to me, you'd all be winners. But it's not. It's not. Charming. But it's not, it's up to our panel of judges who are sitting over there, and they're a motley crew.
Yeah, look at
because
this.
Because they are the crew. So basically, it's up to you to decide. What did you think of the three grannies, crew?
I thought they were fantastic, really, really good.
Don't have to say that. Yeah. Don't have to say it if you don't mean it.
Oh, no.
Don't say it if you don't mean it.
Brilliant.
Okay.
All right, we believe you.
Well, okay, basically, it's in your hands. If you'd like to huddle together.
Huddle.
Have a little talk. Confer on this programme. You can confer.
Huddle. All right, that's enough huddling.
Okay.
So to win this Granny Oakie Award and to go through to Friday's final, who do you think was our karaoke granny of the day?
It was Queenie! Yay!
Congratulations, please take with your award.
Well done, Queenie. Oh, congratulations.
Don't go away empty-handed. We have some lovely flowers for both of you.
Where are they?
Well, we'll give you them later on the show. We have got them.
We'll be having more Granny Oakie tomorrow, but right now it's your chance to win a brilliant holiday to New York in our seasonal competition, Easter Bungee.
Yeah, all you've got to do is watch the programmes coming up later on in the show and answer a simple question about them.
If you answer the question correctly, you'll go into the four people that's already there, you'll go at each of Bungie, 11:20, you'll win a fantastic holiday to America. that's about the short and tall of it.
Basically, you can go to America, can't you?
And the question.
That's the long and the short and the tall of it.
I would say.
That's all that happens. You win and you go to America.
Right, and the question about City Guys is, what make of car does Chris drive?
Who's Chris?
I don't know.
It's in City Guys.
Oh, City Guys, Chris.
And the question again, what make of car does Chris drive? And the number to call is 0891-447-444. That's 0891-447-444. Of course, should cost no more than 25p.
So that question is, what kind of car does Chris drive? Well, let's now watch it. Here it is, City Guys.
C-I-T-Y, you can see why these guys...
Well Welcome back, and indeed, welcome back. This is The Bigger Breakfast, live till 11.30. I'm Ant, and he's Dec.
Dear me.
Now, just before the break, we asked you a question about city guys, and the question was, what was the make of the car that Chris was driving?
Did anybody get it?
No. No.
Why?
No.
Weren't you watching it?
No. Hey? Yeah, what are you doing?
Yeah, right. You?
I was watching it.
What was the answer? What was
it? It was a Ferrari. Right? It was a Ferrari. And the winner of that one, the guy who got it right, was David from Margate. So we put David's up on our Easter bungee board. You're going through to play for a holiday in New York. 11:20. Fair play. Congratulations. Good luck.
Well done, mate.
But if you didn't get through, don't worry. There'll be another New York holiday up for grabs tomorrow. Another one.
Throw them away.
Just give them away.
Give them to the audience. Now, later on, Melanie will be interviewing the guy that made girls swoon just by drinking a can of Diet Cola. Mm. Robert Merrill. Now, if you don't know the name, you'll definitely know the body.
All right.
Saucy.
Now, for no other reason that we want to bring a little smile to your face, Ant and I have composed top five worst little things that we're going to run through all this week. It's called Gimme Five. So Gimme Five, Ant. On the side, up above, down below. You're too slow.
Ah, you're slow.
The first thing today is the top five worst photograph poses.
Now, these get on your nerves, don't they? You go to Boots or something like that.
Yeah.
You get your photos out and say, oh. And we're going to demonstrate those with the help of lovely Lucy. Here she is. She's Lucy. She's got long, luscious legs and she looks like an Afghan hound. Apparently. Anyway, number five, the fifth worst photograph poses are sticking your tongue out and holding up your thumb. This is meant to give the impression you're having a really good time, when in truth, you're not.
Fantastic. The fourth worst photograph pose. You're doing very well, Lucy. Keep it up. The fourth worst is shouting raucously to give the impression that you're having a good time. Now, this is done in the pub with your drink and your thumb up.
Hey!
That's the one.
Remember the pub? Don't forget the thumb, eh? Now, number three, putting two fingers up behind someone's head when you don't know them to make them look like they've got an antenna. We've all done it. That's annoying, but not as annoying as number two.
Number two is putting your arm around someone who you don't really know, or even worse, putting your head in their lap, so it makes it look as if you've got really loads of mates, when in fact you haven't got any. A bit like this.
And the number one worst photograph pose is sticking out your fat stomach and pulling a stupid face in the hope that people will look at the picture and think that you're really slim and athletic in real life when you are actually fat. Here we go.
What's that? What's that for?
Thanks, Bungle.
Well, that's this week's, that's today's top five. No, we're here till 11:30. Please don't go away. This is Channel 4. You're watching The Bigger Breakfast. Take it easy.
Take it easy.
You can win the video of the blockbuster movie Men in Black.
Until 11:30.
There's still to come. We talk to those boys on boys in a snap special.
And Melanie will be talking to the 11:30 diet drink man, Robert Merrill.
Yeah!
And he's
now, I like Robert. You like him?
He's gorgeous, isn't he?
Nice, is he? But I mean, you know, what would you think Dec could do that? Yeah?
I don't want you to be no slave.
Not a patch.
Show our Bobby. No.
Well, I disagree. I think we've got what it takes, Dec, don't you?
I do want you to be no slave.
But if you couldn't get do that, sing it. The theme tune anyway, you know.
Get over it. Plus, someone's going to be flying off to New York in our competition, Easter Bungee.
Right now, though, it's time to go behind the scenes of the Channel 4 programme, City Guys in Snap.
Every day this week, we're taking a trip stateside to catch up.
What are you doing?
Well, this is Robert Merrill, and he's in that fizzy drink sad, and he's absolutely gorgeous, so can you just, like, go away? Like, now.
No, I can't go away, like, now. What are you doing? Hello, Robert, you know,
sorry.
I apologise.
It's so rude.
But, Melanie, you know, what's he got, then, what me and Dec haven't, eh?
Well, I thought this
come
might
on,
happen.
Tell us, go on, what's
Liz,
he got?
Oh, Liz, I know this is happening, so I prepared a list of things that Robert has got that you haven't. Now, you better read that.
Thank you,
so I'm really sorry about this.
All right, yeah. Sorry about that, Rob. I apologise. Yeah.
Yes. Well.
Sorry.
Okay.
Sorry about that. Yeah. No, Dec. No.
Really
no.
Sorry. I'm stunned.
I do apologise.
Declan, he's lost.
I'm really sorry about that.
He's Master Wimberhart.
Just ignore that. Now, luckily for us girls, you're single. So, is it true that you want to meet a special English woman?
Well, that would be nice. I think the English women are...
Get off my land! Get off my land! Hey, oh, we're back on. No, you can come on my land. Come on. Is that good for you?
I like that.
Did it good.
I thought it was pretty good.
That's all right, mate.
Yeah, because now it's time to play our seasonal game, Easter Bungee!
Easter Bungee! Easter Bungee! Easter Bungee!
Hey. And here's our milkmaid Mel to tell you how it works.
Well, rattle my churns. Our poor Easter bunnies have run out of... I can't do this any longer. I've run out of eggs to deliver. They've got to run down these two alleys, grabbing as many eggs as they can in 30 seconds. Meanwhile, Mother Hen is waiting to catch the eggs and put them in her basket. Sounds simple, except that our bunnies are attached to bungee ropes.
Doesn't get any easier.
Doesn't it? And watch out, some of the eggs have special stars on them and they're worth 10 eggs each. And at the end of 30 seconds, we'll count up how many eggs they have managed to get, and all you have to do is guess how many.
That's all you have
That's
to
so
do.
That's so easy. I really explained that so well.
Basically, guess some eggs. That's all you do. Guess some eggs, win a prize. Guess some eggs. Thanks, Milkmaid Mel. Now, I'll collect your churns later.
I warned you about that. You're old enough to be her dad.
I am her dad.
Whoa, now then, who's our first caller there?
Hello.
Is that Esther?
It is indeed.
Hello, Esther.
Where are you calling from today?
I'm calling from Crawley.
Crawley?
Yep.
What's the weather like in Crawley?
Miserable.
Is it?
Miserable.
Oh. Very.
It's not so good down here. Is it grey overcast today?
A bit chilly in the garden too.
It is a bit chilly. How many eggs do you think we're going to get today, Esther?
15.
15?
Yep.
I haven't got my pen. Who's got my pen?
I could remember it with my power of memory.
All right, then.
Okay. Oh, there
Thanks
we go.
Much. That was 15. That's a fire pen.
I've got one.
15.
Just engrave it.
I've got it in there.
Hooray! We got a pen. Thanks a lot. Caller two.
Thanks,
Clive.
Sir.
Are you there, mate? Clive?
I am here. Hi.
Hi, Clive. Where are you calling from?
From Worthing.
From Worthing. How many eggs do you think we'll collect today?
I'm going to go for 12.
12. Ooh, it's a bit cautious, that, isn't it, mate?
All right, then.
Got lots of golden eggs up there.
On line three, we've got John. Hello, John.
Hello.
Where are you calling from today, my love?
Newport, on the Isle of Wight.
Oh, lovely.
Ah.
A holiday on the Isle of Wight is cheaper than you think, you know.
I know.
It is.
It's the paradise of the south,
the Isle of Wight.
Who do you think you are, Judy Chalmers?
Well, I was going to say, John, have you ever been to New York before?
No.
Would you like to go?
I would love to go.
Good luck.
Brilliant.
How many eggs do you reckon?
20.
20? Whoa.
Yeah.
20 eggs.
Good luck to you, John.
Thanks, John. And David on line four, are you there, mate?
Yeah, good morning.
Good morning, how are you?
I'm not too bad, thanks.
Good, where are you calling from?
From Margate.
Margate. We had Dave from Margate. Do you know Dave?
Dave from Margate.
That's me.
Oh, no, sorry, man. I didn't have a pen through his, you know. Is Dave, how many eggs do you reckon?
21.
21.
I can see that. I can see a little strategy there, Dave.
Oh, Scottish, yeah.
All right.
That's a lot of Scottish people go for 21 eggs, Dave.
That's
you know
right.
Scottish stuff to do.
It is, yes. All right, then we've got all our callers there. All we've got to say is it's time to play Easter Bungee. Go.
Are we off?
Are we on?
Whatsoever, yeah.
We've got quite a few coming out.
Hold on.
Give the chicken a hand. Oh, well done. Hang on a minute. This isn't going very well, is it?
Go on.
You all right in there? Oh, no.
Oh, that's it. Time's up. Here we go.
Very good run. Missiles. Okay, let's count up. One, two. No, that's worth 10. That's 11. 21. 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28.
Basically 28, and there's loads more on the grass down there, and I can say that, Dave, you're going to New York, mate. Congratulations.
Fantastic, Dave. Dave, are you still there?
Yes, I'm still here.
What do you do for a living, then?
Well, I work in an ice cream factory.
All right, will you be able to get the time off to go to New York?
Oh, I should hope so.
I hope so, too. Who are you going to take with you?
I'll probably take my fiancée.
Oh, that's lovely of you. What's her name?
It's Pam.
Hello, Pam.
Wait, is she from Margate too?
She is, yes.
All right.
We're getting married on the 31st December, 1999.
Oh, congratulations.
Good luck. Is it a white wedding?
We're supposed to go to Las Vegas.
Oh really? Yep. Las Vegas, New York? Yeah, wow. What a jet setter. Isn't it?
Listen, what are you most looking forward to seeing over there?
The casinos.
Bit of a gambling man.
Listen, best of luck to you, David. Have a brilliant time.
Brilliant.
Have a brilliant time with Pam. Enjoy it. You really deserve it.
Congratulations. Mate. Well done.
And while David's off to pack for his holiday in New York, it's time for us to leave you for another day. And a big thank you to Robert Merrill.
Everybody.
Oh, glamorous grannies.
Yay! And thanks to us. What a great first day. But make sure you join us tomorrow when we're joined by Kid Krill and Ultranate.
We've got lots more snap with boys on.
We're going over to Queenie now to hear a performance again. Is Queenie still? Oh, there's Queenie.
Queenie,
are you coming over?
Oh. Fancy another sing song?
Are you ready?
Here we go, Queenie.
Here
we
take go it again. Away.
Yes, so okay, much, but I don't think you really need me. But if you all stand up in the name of love and state the case of what we're dreaming of,
go, girl.
I've got to say this to you. Whoa, whoa. But like a thief in the night, you took away the love that I knew. Whoa, all together. Here we go. Me, light, my fire. Your love is my only desire. Be like my fire. Cause I need your love. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Oh, hey! Congratulations. I'm glad you won. How do you feel about winning?
Oh, it's lovely.
Yeah? Will your grandchildren be pleased?
Oh, absolutely. But they're so glad. I've got 6 grandchildren, wow. 2 great-grandchildren.
Oh, wow. Yay.
How old are they?
Oh, well, the let's see, I've got 1, 24.
Yeah. They grew up so quickly. Another, it's not last time you've seen you, John.
That's the youngest granddaughter.
Yeah.
Then I've got another one that's 30. Another one that's 28.
So you've got quite a few there. You've got quite a few grandchildren.
Well, you got me all on the spot now.
Hey, don't worry about it. Are you going to step in the show business, do you reckon, Queenie?
Oh, well, no, I shouldn't
think. Yeah, you've done this now, so you're right in performance, isn't it? The Queen.
But I do a little bit of entertaining for old people's clubs.
Well, fantastic. Thanks for coming on the Big Breakfast.
Well,
we'll see you Friday, Queenie.
You've definitely entertained us today. Thank you.
Thanks a lot. We'll see you tomorrow from 7. Bye-bye.
Thanks for coming. Bye.